Hello and welcome to St. Bartholomew's in Armley. I suspect that some of you have been here and seen the church for real, but for the rest of you who perhaps don't find it quite as easy to get here, I hope you feel very welcome and it gives you a chance to hear one of the crowning glories of the building. That first piece, I think, shows off the splendour of the Armley Schulze organ. It's by Théodore Dubois, who was an eminent Parisian organist, director of the Paris Conservatoire, and composer. And I think this piece does reflect its title of Grand Choeur. Certainly is very great or grand. After that, something perhaps rather more smaller scale and a less well-known composer. Mélanie Bonis studied with César Franck, and she had a slight problem wanting to be a composer because composition was not really regarded as a respectable profession for a woman. So instead of calling herself Mélanie, her published name was Mel. And so you never know whether that was a man or a woman. Very crafty. She wrote about 300 works, of which about a tenth were for organ. And I'm going to play three of these pieces, all quite short, but with very different moods. Tranquil, slightly more cheerful, and certainly very loud and lively. So here you go.
Thank you.
after those three pieces by Mélanie Bonis, we turned to Ireland and a rather better known composer, Sir Charles Stanford. I'm sure you know some of his music if you're involved in music for the church or for choirs in general. He wrote, quite remarkably, at the end of World War I, five large-scale sonatas for organ. And this one, this movement that I'm going to play now, is from his Sonata Britannica. It's the middle movement. It starts and finishes with a rather haunting melody, but in the middle it becomes far more turbulent and maybe a touch of triumph, maybe sort of more reflecting the problems of the time. And maybe he was also thinking of some of his pupils who didn't survive the war. After that, another Irishman who became well known for his church music, Charles Wood. And here, in this particular piece, he provides a moment of tranquility and peace, reflecting on the well-known Psalm 23. after those two pieces by Irish composers, we moved to Portugal, and perhaps a rather less familiar figure, Carlos Seixas. He became quite prominent in Portuguese musical life since he was appointed organist of the Imperial Chapel and became very popular as an organist, harpsichordist, teacher, and very prolific composer, although most of his works were lost in the great Lisbon earthquake. This piece, just simple, straightforward, and light texture, which perhaps gives your ears a break after some of the heavier music earlier in my program. And then, for the final piece, we returned to Paris. Eugène Gigout had the remarkable record of being organist of St. Augustine's Church in Paris for 62 years. He was also an eminent teacher, composer, and just about everything else in the musician's life. He was also well known as a recitalist, and he did visit and perform at Halifax Parish Church and in Bradford, as well as Barcelona. And I'll leave you to guess which city provided the inspiration for this final piece in my recital. It's described as a rhapsody on Catalan themes. Most of them, perhaps none of them, you'll know, but don't worry about it. Just enjoy the cheerful rampage to follow. I hope you enjoy.